Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And coming from you from a very cold, rainy Belgium. I do get a lot of questions always, where do you come from? And if I tell people that I am currently in Belgium, they of course pick up on the accent and it doesn't sound anything Belgium. And they are correct. Yeah, I am originally from South Africa in a little town called Port Elizabeth. And I've been living in Belgium for the last 6 years already. So I'm quite miss the sun of South Africa. And I quite miss my friends of South Africa. But of course, I am much closer to the source of the whiskey. So that makes me quite happy. And just as a little bit of additional things, I do like traveling the country. And my job takes me all over the world. So I'm gonna add a little bit of photos of my travels. And I'm going to start on this video. I'm gonna add a little bit of Brussels. What can you see in Brussels? All the nice little buildings that they have. It is a nice place. Antwerp, love it. So tonight, I am continuing with my series on the samples that I bought at a local store here in Belgium, which I'm very grateful for. And as usual, I will put a link on in the description or over here so that you can also go have a look if you are interested in buying some fantastic samples. So they do come in a nice little bottle, quite a generous dram, which I just put a number on it. It is called the top whiskey here in Belgium. So we just add a number to it and then I give you a little spreadsheet with all the details of the whiskey. So I find it very nice if you want to do blind tastings. Just put a couple in front of your friends and let them make it do a blind tasting. I think it's a wonderful idea. And of course it's quite cheap. So this one, I think I only paid €4.50. I think if you go into a pub to taste some of this, it's going to probably, in Belgium, it's going to cost you close to 9-10 euros for this small dram. So quite cost effective, especially for a young whiskey channel. So I'm going to give it a pour. And I'm going to give it a nose and I'm going to give it a taste and a little bit of information on the bottle itself. So it is the Arran Barrel Reserve Single Malt Scotch Whiskey. It is a no age statement whiskey. And it's got, they use first full ex-bourbon cask for the full maturation. Of course, I don't know for how long because they don't give me that information. It is around 27, 28 euros for a bottle of 70 centiliters. And it's bottled at 43% alcohol by volume. So on the nose, cheers. Now, oh, this is nice. It is a light, the first thing that I do get is a vanilla note coming out. Quite a lot of vanilla, but it's a light, floral, fruity nose. A little bit of a berries, or maybe a little bit of a pear and green apple juice that you mix together. You get that fruitiness of it, but it's not overly sweet. Some of the more like a homemade juice that you make by yourself. The sweetness is not like an artificially sweetened apple or pear juice. It's quite fresh. Love it. So the floral note coming out, more like a blossoms, a fruity fruit blossoms, apple blossoms perhaps. and a little bit of a lemon preserve. It reminds me a little bit of a lemon meringue tart. So you get that little hint of lemon and you get the sweetness of the meringue and maybe the custard note. Really nice. And when I get another note, it's like a grapefruit note. When you cut it open, the hint of a grapefruit, that red grapefruit, quite nice on the nose. The alcohol, 43%, I don't get any of that. It's just very light and smooth and noseable. I do kind of like it. It reminds me a little bit of the Glencadam series, which is also matured in ex-bourbon casks. So it reminds me a little bit on that, but not so sweet, a little bit less sweet on the nose for me. Quite nice. On the taste, cheers. Really nice. So it is the alcohol. I don't get it. I don't even get the youthfulness of the alcohol. It's sweet. A little bit of a vanilla note coming out. And then a little bit of the citrus note definitely coming out as well. A little bit of a white chocolate also. The sweetness of white chocolate. So it's quite sweet on the taste. Now I get a little bit of an oak coming out. And I did expect to find some oak. First of all, bourbon cask. There will be a little bit of oak. Because it's first fall, I think there's a lot of the other flavors are still in the wood. And so that draws it out. If I use the second fall, that might not have all the nice stuff still left. So that just draws out the tannins. So for me, this is quite a nice one. Especially nose and taste. Quite nice, quite similar as well. The sweetness is really nice, and you get the citrus note with the second sip, a little bit more elevated citrus note, and it still reminds me of that, of the lemon meringue, the sweetness of maybe the custard in it, the meringue sweetness, so everything works together, and now a little bit of oak. Is appearing a little bit of a pepper note. Very, very nice. Well balanced. You have the sweetness, you have a little bit of a oakiness, and you have a little bit of a citrus note. So quite nice. Like it. It's well rounded. There's nothing that's fighting for your attention. There's nothing that wants to say, pick me, pick me, pick me. This is the predominant note. Everything is standing nicely in line and you get all these little flavors coming out. So my thoughts on it, it is a nice little daily summer sipper. It is quite a cheap whiskey, so it's not going to break the bank. It's a whiskey that you don't really have to think about. This is a whiskey that I will, at any time, if I go to a pub somewhere, I will any time order this one. You don't have to sit and think about it. You just take your whiskey. You don't have to let it stand for 20 minutes in a glass before you have to taste it. You pour it, you drink it, and you enjoy it, and you will have a fantastic experience. Not overly complex, but it's just a nice daily sipper. So I do like it. Will I buy it? Absolutely, I will buy it again. And this is something that I know a lot of my friends is going to love. I know some of my peat lover friends is not going to like it. I think it's going to be way too sweet for them. But it is fantastic for me, perfect for my palate, and especially it does not have a lot of oak in it. So I do like it. So score-wise, I think I'm going to be quite generous because it is my review after all. And I'm going to give it a 78 out of 100. Just because I just like to sometimes just sit, pour a glass, and just to have fun with it and not to overthink everything. So thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe and leave a comment. And what do you think about the Aaron Barrel Reserve? And I see you next time. Cheers.